Okay, coach. It's I know it's a difficult night for you, for the team, but we couldn't forget that PAOK this summer won first time a qualification in Champions League qualification round, first time that passes two rounds in the competition. Does it only have a bitter taste, this trouble?
We had a dream. We fought for this dream. We had a very, very, very tough program, facing teams with much more experience than us at this level, teams that are used to this Champions League groups, teams that come from stronger leagues. And we enjoyed. Yes, today I could say that is a bitter taste, but not specially because we lost in front of a team that is on the ranking on 10th position in this competition. Is because the way of we lost the qualification. We entered very well in the game. We played very aggressive, building up with confidence, creating opportunities, keeping under pressure Benfica. And we also succeeded to score, to lead the game. Unfortunately for us, there were these situations that showed very clear the lack of experience for us at this level. And yes, finally, okay, Benfica, as I said, is much stronger and with much more experience. But they had one opportunity and they scored four goals, and we had a lot of opportunities and we scored just one goal.
Okay, because you will have many journalists to ask you these questions about the game, about technical stuff, about who you put, who you don't put. What we want to do is to attend to the fans. What would you tell to them today to feel confident about the team? What were the lessons that the team took from this competition, and what will carry as an experience to the other competitions that we will participate?
Well, it's obvious that a huge experience. Overcoming this bitterness of missing the qualification will be stronger. We faced very, very good teams. Also today, really, we played very nice, building up, having confidence to receive the ball, to open, to attack them, to upset a team that is very, very strong and play a very good football. The victories against Basel and Spartak Moscow, other teams which they have a higher level, will give us this confidence and this understanding. Step by step, we are going to understand and to understand how tough are games and how important is to keep a strong mentality and a strong confidence. We'll understand to manage such a kind of pressure. The difference between Benfica and PAOK was that Benfica managed much better than us to keep under control the nerves and the pressure. For us, it was obvious that being for the first time and a lot of players having just few games or maybe not games in Champions League, we didn't know to manage this pressure.
Okay, now you will have time to analyze what is the difference between PAOK and Benfica after you see again the games. But I will make the question, what is the difference between Benfica and Panionios? This is my
question. We must come very fast on earth, because it's an important game for the league. We start with minus two. A lot of things happened against us from last year. Also, I cannot avoid this situation. Also, the way and the teams that we faced, comparing with the other team came from last year. We start with minus two from last year. Then we have to be strong enough and tomorrow morning to switch our minds for the game of Sunday.
And when finally Europa League games will start, it's a different competition. PAOK in ranking of this competition is in a high level. What are your dream in this competition? And that's my final question.
Let's let me at least one night to I am going from here to the other. But in any case, to pass the group stage, to pass, to qualify, because this is our mentality and our target. We want to continue the competition after January.
So for us and for you, it's not a goodbye to Champions League. It's a see you later, Champions League. And
For sure, see you later.
And let's face all the other challenges we have in front. Good luck.
Thank you.